हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल आपके इंग्लिश एकेडमी ऑन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज टीचिंग एंड एजुकेशन। आई एम हियर विद अ न्यू टॉपिक ऑन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर। इट इज पार्ट वन ऑफ 50 फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क्ड क्वेश्चंस इन यूजीसी नेट एग्जाम्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल फॉर द लेटेस्ट अपडेट्स ऑन न्यू वीडियोज ऑन इंग्लिश लिटरेचर फॉर यूजीसी नेट एग्जाम्स एंड सेट एग्जाम्स एंड JRF एटसेट्रा। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज द प्यूरिटन्स शट डाउन ऑल थिएटर्स इन इंग्लैंड इन 1642। यस फ्रेंड्स, द आंसर इज 1642। इन दिस ईयर द प्यूरिटन्स शट डाउन ऑल द थिएटर्स इन इंग्लैंड जस्ट आफ्टर द फर्स्ट सिविल इंग्लिश सिविल वॉर इन सेप्टेम्बर 1642 इट वॉज शट डाउन। प्यूरिटन्स बिलीव्ड दैट थिएटर्स कुड स्प्रेड frivolous lies and papist propaganda among the population. This was the reason on the basis of it they shut down all the theaters. Next one, in Rape of the Lock, Pope repeatedly compares Belinda to the sun. Yes friends, Belinda is so much beautiful and charming. She was a woman of super beauty and charm. In the beginning of Canto 2, she was compared to the sun, as brightness of her eyes surpasses the brightness of the sun. Yes friends. Next one, in Dryden's Essay of Dramatic Poesy, who opens the discussion on behalf of the ancients? Who opens the discussion in this work? So it was Crites. Yes friends. Dryden was the first poet laureate of England, as we know. He attempted to justify drama as legitimate form of poetry comparable to the epic, as well as defend English drama against that of the ancients and the French. This essay was written probably during the plague year in around 1666 and first published in 1668. It is a dialogue between four different speakers. Crites is one of them. The four different speakers are there. The next question is, which Shakespearean play contains the line "there is special providence in the fall of a sparrow"? It was Hamlet. Yes friends, in Hamlet this line occurs. This quote comes in the act 5 scene 2 of Hamlet by Shakespeare, suggesting that a divine power takes a benevolent interest in human affairs. Next one is, in which of his essays does Homi Bhabha discuss the discovery of English in colonial India? It is Science Taken for Wonders. Homi Bhabha is an Indian English scholar and a critical theorist as well. He is an important figure in contemporary post-colonial studies. His key concepts and theories include hybridity, mimicry, difference, ambivalence, and third space. These are five different theories given by him. Once again, I repeat, hybridity, mimicry, difference, ambivalence, and third space. Yes, friends. Next one is, Kubla Khan takes an epigraph from Samuel Purkas, His Pilgrimage. Yes, the epigraph of Kubla Khan is taken from this work. It is a subtitle, its subtitle is A Vision in a Dream, a fragment written by S.T. Coleridge, completed in 1797 but published in 1816. The book described Xanadu. Yes, it is a place, the summer capital of Mongol ruler Kublai Khan. The next one is, what does the term episteme signify? The answer is knowledge. Yes friends, we have heard about epistemology, a study of knowledge. In the same way, episteme is a philosophical term referring to a principled system of understanding and scientific knowledge. Next one, whom did Keats regard as the prime example of negative capability? It is William Shakespeare. Negative capability was first used by John Keats, the romantic poet, in 1817. to characterize the capacity of the greatest writers, particularly Shakespeare. Yes. Next one is Charles Dickens' A Tale of Two Cities begins with this sentence: "It was the best of times. It was the worst of times." Yes, friends. It is very much important question. A Tale of Two Cities is a historical novel by Charles Dickens, published in 1859. The two cities are London and Paris before and during French Revolution. Next one is the works of Gerald Manley Hopkins, G.M. Hopkins, were published posthumously by Robert Bridges. Yes, friends. G.M. Hopkins was one of the greatest poets of the Victorian era. His works were not published until 30 years after his death. That's why when his friend Robert Bridges edited the volume Poems and published it, so it was published posthumously by Robert Bridges. Next one is the preliminary version of James Joyce's portrait of the artist as a young man was called Stephen Hero. Yes, friends. Stephen Hero is also another title of this work. It is the first novel of James Joyce, published in 1916. Story of Stephen Dedalus, the hero of the novel, the protagonist. With a small difference in title, Portrait of an Artist as a Young Dog was written by Dylan Thomas also. Yes, friends. Another work is there with the same title, but a little bit difference is there. Dog word is used, and it is written by Dylan Thomas as a portrait of an artist as a young dog. Yes, it is a collection of short prose stories published in 1940. Next one is, which book by V.S. Naipaul is subtitled as The Caribbean Revisited? It is The Middle Passage. The Middle Passage is a travelogue actually by V.S. Naipaul. This book covers a year-long trio through Trinidad, British Guiana, Suriname, Martinique, and Jamaica in 1961. V.S. Naipaul has received the Nobel Prize in Literature in 2001. Yes, friends, it is very important. He received the Nobel Prize in 2001. Another one is, in the closing paragraph of the trial, two men accompany Joseph K. to a part of the city to eventually execute him. The place is a quarry. Yes, Joseph K. is the protagonist of the allegorical novel The Trial, published in 1925 by Franz Kafka. The writer is Franz Kafka, published his novel The Trial in 1925. Joseph K. is the protagonist of the novel. He was arrested for an unspecified crime and was executed by two men outside the town in a quarry. Next one, in Practical Criticism, I.A. Richards links four different kinds of meanings in most human utterances to four aspects. These are sense, feeling, tone, and intention. So I.A. Richards, very famous and popular critic of English literature, Practical Criticism is a theory by him. He explains four different types of functions or meaning that the language has to perform. Richards also found two kinds of belief and disbelief. These two kinds of belief and disbelief are intellectual belief and emotional belief. Once again, intellectual belief and emotional belief, he propounded two kinds of beliefs. Okay, next one. Who is John Keats' Sylvan historian? Sylvan historian, it is the Grecian urn. Sylvan means an inhabitant of forest, which is a person, animal, or spirit living in a forest. Yes, friends. Next one is, D.H. Lawrence uses the expression "a bright book of life" to describe the novel. Yes, for describing a novel, he used this phrase. D.H. Lawrence is particularly known for his novels like Sons and Lovers, Woman in Love, and Lady Chatterley's Lover. Very important work by him, Lady Chatterley's Lover. नेक्स्ट वन, व्हाट ऑल्टरनेटिव टाइटल टू हर फ्रैंकेनस्टीन डिड मैरी शेली गिव? इट वाज द मॉडर्न प्रोमेथियस. यस, मॉडर्न प्रोमेथियस इज द अनदर टाइटल, ऑल्टरनेटिव टाइटल गिवन बाय मैरी शेली टू हर वर्क. मैरी शेली वॉज एन इंग्लिश नॉवलिस्ट फेमस फॉर हर गोथिक नॉवल. यस, गोथिक नॉवल्स शी हैज रिटन अ लॉट. फ्रैंकेनस्टीन पब्लिश्ड इन 1818. इट वॉज लॉर्ड बायरन who suggested her to write a ghost story when she stayed in a manor of Lake Geneva with her future husband B.B. Shelley. Yes. Another one is, there is nothing outside the text is a statement by Jacques Derrida. Very, very famous statement given by him. There is nothing outside the text, Jacques Derrida. Jacques Derrida was French philosopher best known for developing a form of semiotic analysis known as deconstruction. Yes, friends, deconstruction is his very famous theory. The next one is, what is the following a description of? The description is given here, a loose shelly of the mind, an irregular indigested piece. It is called essay. Yes, this definition of essay is given by Samuel Johnson. Samuel Johnson gave this definition for essay. He says that a loose shelly of the mind, an irregular indigested piece, not regular or orderly composition. Yes, friends. So, the next one, G.M. Hopkins' Windhover is dedicated to Christ our Lord. The Windhover is a sonnet written in 1887, but published after a long time in 1918. As we discussed earlier, Robert Bridges published his poems. So, after a long time, it was published in 1918, but written in 1887. It is a volume of collected poems. The next one, Leopold Bloom in Ulysses is a Jewish advertising agent. Leopold Bloom is a character in this novel. Leopold Bloom is a protagonist and hero of the novel Ulysses by James Joyce, published in 1922. Next question. The tramp in Pinter's first big hit, The Caretaker, often travels under an assumed name. The name is Bernard Jenkins. He travels with an assumed name of Bernard Jenkins. The Caretaker is a three-act play by Harold Pinter. Tramp means a person who always likes to wandering all around. Bernard Jenkins is a name that he assumed. His actual name was Mac Davis. Yes, his actual name was Mac Davis. The next one is, where does Act 1 of William Congreve's Way of the World open? The Chocolate House. It opens in Chocolate House. Yes, friends, the Way of the World is one of the best restoration comedies. It has characters like Millamant, Mirabel, Lady Wishfort, and Foible. Foible is the servant of Lady Wishfort. The next one is, brother to a prince and fellow to a beggar, if he be found worthy. This is the epigraph to Rudyard Kipling's The Man Who Would Be the King. Yes, this epigraph is attached to this work by Rudyard Kipling, The Man Who Would Be the King. It is a story by Rudyard Kipling about two British adventurers in British India. It was first published in The Phantom Rickshaw and Other Eerie Tales in 1888. Next one is, at the end of The Great Gatsby, the narrator Nick Carraway observes they were careless people. Who were they? Two people were there, Tom and Daisy. The Great Gatsby is a novel written by F. Scott Fitzgerald in 1925, perhaps the greatest novel ever written in the history of English literature. The next one is Samuel Johnson's Lives of Poets, published in नेक्स्ट वन इज सैमुअल जॉनसन्स लाइव्स ऑफ पोएट्स पब्लिश्ड इन 1781 वाज ओरिजिनली अ सीरीज ऑफ इंट्रोडक्शंस ऑफ द पोएट्स ही रॉट फॉर अ ग्रुप ऑफ लंडन पब्लिशर्स दे वर कलेक्टेड एज प्रीफेसिस बायोग्राफिकल एंड क्रिटिकल टू द वर्क्स ऑफ इंग्लिश पोएट्स. यस फ्रेंड्स, Lives of the Poets comprises of biographies and critical appraisals of 52 poets. It is Johnson's last great work. Next one is arrange the sections of the wasteland in the order in which they appear in the poem. Yes, wasteland has five different sections written by T.S. Eliot. It is the burial of the dead, a game of chess, the fire summon, death by water, what the thunder said. I have created one short trick to remember this. BGFDW. B for burial of the dead, G for game of chess, F for fire summon, and D for death by water, and last one, W for what the thunder said. The Wasteland is a central work of modernist poetry by Eliot. It was published in 1922 with 434 lines, appeared first in Eliot's The Criterion, the October issue, and then in the Dial, the November issue. Two issues were published at that time. The Criterion issue, it was October issue, and the Dial, it was November issue. And it was published, this Wasteland was published in both these issues. Next one. The character of Sir Plum appears in Pope's The Rape of the Law. Sir Plum was Belinda's brother in The Rape of the Law. It is a mock heroic epic poem written by Alexander Pope, appeared in 1712 with three cantos in it. And then once again appeared in 1714 including two more cantos, total five cantos. In Black's poem A Poison Tree, the speaker's anger grows and becomes an apple. Yes, speaker's anger becomes an apple after growing in the poison tree, a poem by William Blake. It is a poem which gives us a message that if we hold anger within and nurture it, it is poisonous and can harm others too. Next one, Thomas More's Utopia displays strong influence of Plato's Republic and Amerigo Vespucci's account of the travels. Yes, two things influenced this work by Thomas More. It was Plato's Republic and Amerigo Vespucci's account of the travels. Utopia is a perfect imaginary world described by Thomas More. This is a work of fiction published by him in 1516. You can remember it's 1516. It's easy. The next one, in his attack delivered on the theater in short view of the immortality and profaneness of the English stage, Jeremy Collier specially arraigned. These two writers were Congreve and Vanbrugh. A short view of the immortality and profaneness of English stage is an anti-theater pamphlet. It is a pamphlet actually by Jeremy Collier, published in 1698. This pamphlet attacks a number of playwrights. William Wycherley is there, John Dryden is there, William Congreve, John Vanbrugh, etc. So in this pamphlet Jeremy attacked different writers. Next one, according to Hardy, a particular poem by Wordsworth was his best cure for despair. Which is this poem? Which is that poem? That poem is The Leech Gatherer. The Leech Gatherer is also called Resolution and Independence, composed in 1802. It's another name, we can say Resolution and Independence. The poem's another name. It was published by Wordsworth in 1802 and published once again in 1807 with two more volumes. Yes, two more volumes were added at that time in 1807 when it was published. Next one is, how would you best describe George Meredith's Modern Love? It is a sonnet sequence. Yes, friends. Modern Love is a collection of 50 different sonnets about the failure of his marriage. And each sonnet contains 16 lines. In every sonnet, there are 16 lines. So, total 50 sonnets and 16 lines in each sonnet. The next one is, J.M. Coetzee was the first writer to be awarded the Booker Prize twice. Two times he was awarded Booker Prize. He won the prize for Life and Times of Michael Kay and Disgrace. So, two different works by him. First one is Life and Times of Michael Kay, and another one is Disgrace. For the first time, Life and Times of Michael Kay, in 1983 he received Booker Prize, and second for Disgrace in 1999. He was also a nominee for Booker Prize in 2009 for his Summertime, for his work Summertime in 2009. So two different works are there, and in which year? Life and Times of Michael Kay in 1983 and Disgrace in 1999. Another one is, which playwright scripted the film Shakespeare in Love? It was Tom Stoppard. Shakespeare in Love is a 1998 romantic period comedy drama film. Next one is, the Irish dramatist movement was heralded by such figures as W.B. Yeats, Lady Gregory and Edward Martin. W.B. Yeats was the leader of this movement. He established Irish Literary Society in London. He was also responsible for founding Irish Literary Theatre in Dublin. Yes, friends, he founded in Dublin the Irish Literary Theatre, and the most important writer of this society, Irish Literary Society. The leader of this movement was W.B. Yeats, and other writers were Lady Gregory and Edward Martin. Which poem by Chaucer was written on the death of Blanche, wife of Jonot Count? The Book of Duchess. Yes, it is the first work by Chaucer, a major poem by Chaucer written in a dream vision. Yes, it is written in dream vision, also known as the Dream of Chaucer. Okay, friends, the Book of Duchess is known as the Dream of Chaucer. The next one is, the Tragedy of Ferrex and Porrex is the other title of Gorboduc. Yes, Gorboduc is the earliest English tragedy in blank verse written by Thomas Sackville and Thomas Norton in 1561. Gorboduc is the earliest English tragedy in blank verse written by Thomas Sackville and Thomas Norton. Two different people were there, Sackville and Norton, who published this tragedy in 1561. He found it brick and left it marble. It is about English language. He found English brick and left it marble, remarked one great writer on another. Who were they? It was Johnson on Dryden. Johnson remarked on Dryden. Dryden was a poet laureate, as we know, from 1668 to 1689, for 21 years. Johnson, in his Life of Dryden, remarked about this statement. Yes, friends. Next question is, C.K. Ogden and I.A. Richards were reputed in the 1930s for introducing the Basic English Project. They collaborated and presented this project. This project was presented in Ogden's book, Basic English. It was presented in a book named Basic English, General Introduction with Rules and Grammar, published in 1930 by Ogden. The next one is, Arts for Art's Sake became a rallying cry for aesthetics. Yes, friends. Art for art's sake is a French slogan showing the value of art, and it is a movement in literary writing. Another one is Confessions of an English Opium Eater, is a literary work by Thomas D. Quincey. This one is an autobiographical account, became very popular at that time after publishing. The next one is, in which travel book does Mark Twain give an account of his visit to India? It was Following the Equator. This is a travelogue by Mark Twain, published in 1897. This work is also sometimes titled as More Tramps Abroad. Another title is More Tramps Abroad. The next one is William Blake's famous poems such as London, The Silk Rose, and The Tiger appear in Songs of Experience. Friends, Songs of Experience is a collection of poems by William Blake, Songs of Experience and Songs of Innocence. It is a collection of illustrated poems. Songs of Innocence, published in 1789, containing 19 poems, and Songs of Experience, published in 1794, containing 26 poems. Once again, I repeat the answer. Songs of Innocence, published in 1789, with 19 poems, and Songs of Experience, published in 1794, with 26 poems. So, there are more poems in Songs of Experience. Another one is, the term the comedy of menace is associated with the early plays of Harold Pinter. It is a play in which the laughter of the audience in some or all situations is immediately followed by a feeling of some impending disaster. Yes, after the comedy comes impending disaster. So it is called Comedy of Menace, along with Harold Pinter, David Campton, Nigel Dennis, N. F. Simpson are associated with Comedy of Menace. The next one is, the words, if it were done when 'tis done, then 'twere well it were done quickly, are uttered by Macbeth. It is in Old English by Shakespeare. Macbeth spoke these words in the play named Macbeth. This statement was spoken by Macbeth in Act 1, Scene 7 of the play. It is a soliloquy of Macbeth, self-conversation, we can say, of Macbeth. The next one is, Thomas Love Peacock classified poetry into four different periods. They are iron, gold, silver, and brass. Okay, friends. So it is the four ages of poetry he described in his essay. Thomas Love Peacock described these ages of poetry in his essay, where he classified poetry in four different ages. Yes. What is a neologism? A word newly coined or used in a new sense. It is neologism. It is its definition. Word newly coined or used in a new sense. That is neologism. It is a newly created word used in expressions in both writing and speaking. For example, the word webinar nowadays, it is used for seminar, web for internet. Okay, in that sense, the word you newly coined or used in a new sense, that is called neologism. The next one is, who wrote the essay Naipaul's India and Mine? It was Nazim Ezekiel. He wrote the essay Naipaul's India and Mine. This essay was written by Ezekiel as a reply. It was written as a reply to Naipaul's work, An Area of Darkness. Naipaul wrote one work, An Area of Darkness, about India. So, as a reply, Ezekiel wrote this essay as Naipaul's India and Mine. So, friends, that's all for today. We have attended so many questions today. These questions were asked by UGC NET exam setters, and too many times these were asked, frequently asked questions these are, and in next exams it can be asked again. So we should have the knowledge of these questions. So this was only the part one. I will share another video very soon on the same topic. I will share another 50 questions very soon. Till then, all the best for your preparation, and that's all for today, friends. On this channel, I will be sharing more videos on English literature on various topics. Thank you and Jai Hind.